tuck it in. Now that's inside the groove. Now all I have to do is I'm going to twist this up, and you can see I can roll the edges in as I'm going around this thing. And eventually I get to the end. You just push it back in with a screwdriver. There we go. There we go, all the way back in. Now I see.
Yeah. When you're using your screwdriver so vigorously, is that gonna, are you worried about marring the inside of that drum?
Well, I'm not worried about scratching this. You know, I suppose if you put a mark in here, it's possible, but that'd have to be a heck of a gouge. And more particularly, that's steel.
Yeah.
So I'm not too worried on this one, but you're right. If you got an aluminum drum on a newer,
you wouldn't want to be digging in like that.
I'm forced to have it, though. I've built so many of these stupid transmissions, I don't worry on this one, but yeah, it's a good point to make. Okay, this guy, the little barrel part goes down, the flat part goes up. Now, if I disassemble this correctly, I should be able to just drop that in, start bringing my clutches back in. Now, on this first transmission, we're just doing the exercise of how to take it apart, put it back together. Were I rebuilding this, I would have taken my new clutches from my new rebuild kit, and I would have soaked them all in ATF. I want them soaked thoroughly so I'm not putting in dry clutches that are gonna burn up. In this one's case, we're just practicing reassembly. So I'm gonna restack them all.
So ATF acts like a lubricant or something?
Well, these clutches are wet clutches. They should be 24/7 soaked in ATF. They're never meant to be dry. And if I rebuild a transmission with dry clutches, it takes a while for fluid to get up here and splash on and soak them in. So that first five or six times I go to shift, right after I rebuild it, I've got clutches with no lubricant, no friction modifier, no protection. And you're going to wear mileage off them. So there's a few habits I'll get you guys started on. Today we're just going after reassembly. Okay, same thing. This isn't directional, but I'm still going to keep that practice. And just like before, take just one leading edge, tuck it in, and what you can see is I can simply hold this end up and just kind of squeeze it all back together and goes back in. That's one of those things, practice a few times, it just becomes second nature. Now when I'm done, I should be able to rotate and move these clutches around. If I can't twist them around, something's gone horribly wrong. I'm not even going to go to the step of taking my feeler gauges or my dial indicator and measure it. But as long as it moves around, I can wiggle a little bit. I'll go on to the step of measuring, which we're going to do on Wednesday. We're not going to do today. Here's what I'd like to see before we turn our tools and call it an evening. I need a couple things. One, make sure this is laid out really well. They should be nice and safe till Wednesday. It's just the electrical class in here tomorrow. Make sure the rest of these things haven't gotten disturbed. Have this guy reassembled and safely standing up somewhere. And the last thing I need is this form. We have just completed this, and we've actually started the next form. I'll hand that one out on Wednesday. But make sure this is filled in, and more importantly, your name must be here. If I don't have a name there, I can't give you credit for this first part of the project.